Hi guys, I am Marlon Natividad.
And I'm Jean.
Hi, I'm Olego.
And we're going to show to all of you how to solve the decile or group data. So let's go.
This is the daily allowance of 60 students, and this is the class interval. We have frequency, we have a lower boundary, we have a cumulative frequency. As you can see, we already have a frequency, which is the tally of the class interval. So now I'll teach you how to get the lower boundary. All you have to do is just take a look at the first column in a interval, which is 81, 71, 61, 51, 41, 31, 21, 11, and 1. All you have to do when you get all of that is just minus 0.5. So I'll teach you how. 81 minus 0.5 is 80.5. 71 minus 0.5 is 70.5. 61, and do it all to the rest. 60 minus 0.5, 60.5. 51, 50.5. 41, 40.5. 31, 30.5. 21, 20.5. 11, 10.5. 1 minus 0.5 is, of course, 0.5. So it's okay. Although you erase this, after we got all of the lower boundary, all we have to plus or add the all of the frequency here. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 6 plus 12 plus 4 plus 15 plus 10 plus 7 is the total of all of that is 60. We will write it on the lower column in frequency, which is 60. Total. That, like that. And now we're done how to get the frequency, and we're going to the next part on how to get the cumulative frequency. All you have to do is just put the frequency here, add it on from lower to upper. First, one. We have nothing to add, so we will put first the one in the cumulative frequency here. 1. 1 plus 2 equals 3. So 3 plus 3 equals 6. 6 plus 6 equals 12. 12 plus 12 equals 24. 24 plus 4 equals 28. 28 plus 15 is 43. 43 plus 10 equals 53. So 53 plus 7 equals 60. As you can see, the first cumulative frequency here is 60, and the total of the frequency is 60 is the same. So if that, you're right. If the first cumulative frequency is 60 and the total is 60, if it's precise, it means you're right. So after we get the class interval, frequency, a lower boundary, and the cumulative frequency, now I will show you the formula for decile for group data. Decile for group data. So here's the formula for I'll show you what is the formula. This LB stands for lower boundary. And the DK, D is the decile mean, and the K is the number of the DK. And I'll teach you, and I'll go into to discuss what is this K. And K, and this is the N, equals the equivalent for N is the total. And when you get that, all you have to do is divide it to 10. And CFB, that means, CFB stands for cumulative frequency. And now we have frequency, and this is the interval. So now we know what is the formula. Now we're going to tell the meaning of those. We have LB, N, F, F, I. So the meaning of LB is lower boundary of DK class. Of the DK class. And the N is the total frequency. CF is cumulative frequency. before DK class. So we have L, frequency of DK class. So I is the size of class interval. K is the nth decile. Nth decile, where n is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, and on and on and on. So now we're going to solve the D6. So first, all you have to do is zero for me. And now, first, all we have to do is times the k and n and divide it to 10. So our k is stands for 6, so write it on, 6. And n is stands for the total frequency, and we have to take a look back at the first photo recently that we did. So now we know what is the n or total frequency, and that is 60. And put the 10. 6 times 60 is equals for 360, and 360 divide 10. So 360 divide 10 is equals to 36. All we have to do is find 36 in cumulative frequency. So 36, so 43. 43, the 43 inside the 43, 36 is circulating inside the 43. So we're going to take the line of similarity frequency. We're going to write it, yes. So this is the, so this is the line. But first, when we get that frequency lower boundary, we're going to down. So our cumulative frequency is not 43, it's 28. Our cumulative frequency is 28, our lower boundary is 60.5, and our frequency is 15. And now we know what is our given, and those given are LB is equals to 60.5, and CFB is equals to 28, and our FDK is equals to 15, and our interval, or our I, is 10, and our N, or total frequency, is 60. Now, after we know what is our given, we have to solve the problem. All we have to do is just follow the formula. And let's go, and we're going to rewrite it. DK equals LB. LB is equal to 60.5, so we're going to write it 60.5. And KN divided by 10, and that is 66 equals CFB, which is 28, divided to FDK, which is 15, and times an interval, which is 10. And we're going to put plus here. So 60.5 plus. So 36 minus 28 is equals to 8. So we're going to write it 8 divide 15 times 10. And now 60.5 plus. All we have to do is just times the 8 and 10. 8 times 10 equals 480. 80 divided by 15. So 80 divided by 15 is equals for 5.33. So all we have to do is write it first. 60.5 plus 5.33. So we already get it. So now we already have to do is just add this 2. So 60.5 plus 5.33 is equals for 65.83. 65.83. So now, our D6 is equals 4,